हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे विल सी सिंपल टेक्निक फॉर ब्लोइंग कॉक शेल और व्हाट वी कॉल्ड शंख, ब्लोइंग अ शंख, ब्लोइंग अ कॉक शेल। दिस इज द कॉक शेल। सो बेसिकली कॉक शेल इज एनक्लोज्ड कैविटी। वी हैव टू इनपुट एयर हियर एंड विल गेट sound from here, this portion. So there are basically three steps to blow a conch shell. First step is to provide a vibrating sound through the lips. At the same time we need to blow air. That's the first step. Second step is to lock the lips in place when we are blowing the conch shell. And third step is to have a sustained sound, prolonged time. We need to blow maybe 20 seconds, 30 seconds, depending on our experience or how much we have the capacity of our lungs. So these are basically three steps to blow a conch shell. So to start with, first step is to provide a vibrating sound through the lips. Basically, if you just remove air, conch shell will not produce sound. So to produce sound, we need to provide a vibrating sound like this. The lips should vibrate, and small amount of air we need to input. That is first thing. Second, once we get the sound by blowing in the conch shell, we need to lock our lips. Locking the lips is, suppose we are blowing conch shell like this, the air should not pass from the side of the hole where we are blowing. So either we can take the conch shell towards our lips like this, or we can take our lips towards conch shell and apply little pressure, so air should not go out. So air should be blown in this hole, so in an enclosed cavity the air should not go out. So that is second step. And third step is a prolonged time we need to blow, like sustained. If you are taking in air So this is the capacity of my lungs. So depending on the lungs capacity of other people, they need to practice it. Through the practice we'll get that. So we can blow the conch shell for a certain amount of time. These are the three steps. So let's see, practice this on the conch shell. This is the conch shell. So in this is 7-8 inch conch shell length. If a conch shell is big in size, you can easily blow it. If it's very small, you need to apply more pressure because the cavity is small. So let's practice on this. First we'll vibrate our lips and then place the conch shell so we can hear the sound. This is the first step. Second is, we'll apply the first step and then lock our lips, like give little pressure to conch shell. So this is the second step. A third step is to practice the second step for a certain amount of period, depending on the capacity of the lungs of a person, and based on that we can increase the blowing capacity. We'll blow it once. Also there is another simple step which we can follow, like we can do like this. So you will come to know where the sound is good. At one position of the conch shell, you get maximum sound. So this is the position. So these are the basic three steps of blowing any conch shell. Depending on the size of the conch, the sound varies. This is another conch shell. This is unpolished. Unpolished means on the top of this there is algae. You can see it's not removed. So the sound of this is will be different because the cavity is little different. You can check. That's one thing. Second, so this is first, this is the procedure how to blow a conch shell. Then the important thing here is the diameter of the hole. It should be such that it should easily be able to blow the conch shell, and it should be easy for the lips to rest. Some place must be there here to so the lips can rest. If the diameter is very big, air can escape through the side of this. So here the diameter of this what we have in this conch shell is around 13 to 15 mm. Here also same thing, it's little more than 15, but here there is a resting place, that is also very important. So these are the few things which you need to take care of during buying a conch shell, and follow the three steps so anybody can blow a conch shell, a shank. First is removing vibrating sound. Second is locking the lips by either pressing this, taking the conch shell towards lip like this, or you can put a pressure of your lips on the conch shell. Second step. And third step is prolonged time, like depending on the capacity of person, how much they can blow, that much only, for that much time they can blow and stop. By increasing the time, by practicing, you can increase the time of blowing a conch shell. So basically follow these three steps and follow the basic things like during buying a conch shell, like the resting face should be there, the hole should be like around minimum 10-15 mm diameter based. It's very big, then it's the air can escape. So these are the basics things while buying a conch shell, and through practice anybody can blow a conch shell. If through practice you can even blow two conch shells. I'll just show you, like it's not a big deal. So you need to hold the two conch shells, check the position where they blow, and then blow the air. Once we practice, we can learn the art of blowing two conch shells. One. Okay. Bye-bye.